presentation will give a short demonstration of some of the key features of the DS11 Series Spectrophotometer Fluorometer. The Novix is based in Wilmington, Delaware, and was established in 2012 by Fred Keelhorn, one of the original founders of nanodrop technologies. In 2013, we launched the DS11 Series, introducing our patented SmartPath technology. Since that time, we've continued to innovate to expand the DS11 series to include fluorescence capabilities. And in 2019, we launched the Cell Drop Automated Cell Counter, the only instrument of its kind to count cells without slides, reducing plastic waste and saving labs money. Since its launch, the DS11 series has received more online reviews than any other instrument, and it's twice been awarded Life Science Product of the Year. It was also the first instrument to be awarded the prestigious Platinum Seal of Quality. The model I'm using here today is the DS11 FX Plus. This integrates all three of the measurement modes in the DS11 series. A range of models is also available that allow researchers to choose from any configuration of modes to suit their laboratory's current and future needs. Firstly, we have the microvolume absorbance. So this is full spectrum UV vis in 1 microliter samples, and there's 1 microliter pipetted directly onto the front pedestal here. We also have cuvette absorbance. So again, this is full spectrum UV vis. This is a heated position, so it takes all standard cuvette sizes, and this can heat 37 through to 42 degrees Celsius. So commonly people are using this for the biochemical assays, for kinetic assays, but also for things like OD600 measurements, so quantifying microbial cell cultures. Something that's unique to the DS11 series is we also have an integrated fluorometer. So this fluorometer is a 4-channel fluorescence instrument that measures fluorescence in 0.5mm thin wall PCR tubes. And we'll talk a little bit more about fluorescence and the importance of it as we go through this presentation. So if we look at the instrument itself, the instrument is controlled by this touchscreen interface, so a high definition touchscreen interface. And all of the applications are separated into measurement apps. So you'll see on the screen we have a series of square apps along the top and along the bottom. These are all our UV vis apps. In the center we have some fluorescence apps, and they're all circular by design. And then we can swipe through to the second page. And here we have some additional measurement apps such as peptides and kinetics, but also some of the housekeeping functions for the DS11 series. So things like diagnostics to check correct working of the instrument. We have that for UV vis and for fluorescence. And also here we set up things like user accounts, so they can be password protected user accounts for the instrument. And also we have a number of other functions like calculators and timers, and we can update software and set up our general settings from that page. And to the rear of the instrument, we have 3 USB ports. These can be used for USB memory drives, for barcode scanners, for a label printer, or to attach a keyboard and mouse. We also have a Ethernet connector. So this instrument and these series of instruments can connect to your network either through Ethernet, or we have onboard Wi-Fi as well. So what this allows us to do is to actually give you a range of exporting options that can use the internet, use network drives, as well as we can use things like USB memory sticks. Coming onto the touchscreen at the front, we can see all of the measurement apps are broken down into different applications. And the reason for this is just to avoid any potential mistakes. So we have different color coding for different types of analytes. So it's very clear which one is used for DNA, which is RNA, single-stranded DNA or protein. So for the purposes of this demonstration, we're going to concentrate first on double-stranded DNA, and then we'll take a little look at some of the other measurement apps and show you some of the kind of unique characteristics of those. So first thing we need to do is just start up the app just by touching it. And you'll see, and you'll hear, as you start up any measurement app, it goes through an initialization. And what this does is the high precision screw that sets the path length, so it sets the height of the top measurement arm, goes through a routine where it finds its home position, and from that it can calculate any path length. So it knows exactly how many turns it takes to reach any particular path length. And this is a really key feature for the DS11. Because the characteristics of that screw and how many revolutions it takes never changes over the lifetime of the instrument, we don't require any additional calibration checks or setting the calibration every 6 months or 12 months. So you don't require an engineer to come out and test your instrument and recalibrate it. We can guarantee that it's always within calibration. So when we come into the measurement app, we can see it's quite a simple screen, simple layout to it. So you get access to the information that you need very quickly. We have a blank and a measure button in the top left-hand corner. You'll notice that the measure button is greyed out until you provide a blank to the system. So it's important, or it's essential, that you have a blank for your sample. We can see we have an auto run feature, and this just allows us to actually automatically run a sample without touching the measure button as the arm closes. So if we've got a big batch of samples, it's a nice little time saver. And I'll show you how that works during the process of the demo. We can choose between microvolume and cuvette mode using the drop-down menu. And on the right-hand side, this is where our data will appear. So we'll just put on our blank. And it's important that our blank is the appropriate blank for our sample. So by that, I mean that it should be whatever your sample is suspended in minus the analyte of interest. So if your DNA is in T buffer, this should be a T blank, for example. During this blank cycle, as you'll hear the light firing, and the arm will move down and take the blank at various path lengths, and it stores that and uses that as a reference spectrum when we measure our sample. So we correct for anything that's in your blanks. You're just measuring exactly what is in your sample. It just takes a couple of seconds, and you'll see that when it's finished, the measure button becomes active, and all we do is we wipe the blank away. So as soon as we've made our blank measurement, we're ready for our first sample. So we take a 1 microliter aliquot and pipette it onto the lower measurement surface and just move the arm down. So at this stage, we have the option to enter a sample name, either using the keypad, or we can scan in a barcode, or we can leave this until after we've run our samples and enter the sample names later. We can also select from the user accounts that we've set up, and then we just hit measure. Capturing the data just takes a couple of seconds, but at this stage it's worth taking the opportunity to explain how the DS11 series captures that data in a different way to other microvolume spectrophotometers. At the heart of all microvolume measurements on the DS11 series is a unique process called smart path technology. So this is a combination of proprietary algorithms developed by Denovix to deliver ultra-precise measurements. And it uses real-time feedback assessments on the absorbance to determine the optimum path length with which to measure the sample. And what you'll see if you look at the sample being measured is the top arm comes down, touch the sample, and then continually compresses the sample until that optimum path length is reached. So this measurement process addresses one of the major concerns that labs often have with microvolume spectrophotometers, especially those labs that are measuring proteins, and that is sample column breakage. This is a phenomenon you might observe on instruments that stretch the sample between two measurement surfaces. And it's a situation where the sample doesn't bridge between those measurement surfaces, and it results in inaccurate data. So returning to our sample, we can zoom in on our trace if we want to get a better look at this. We can zoom back out again. But the data is displayed here on the right-hand side. So you'll see we have a concentration in nanograms per microliter for double-stranded DNA. We have the absorbance value, and then we also have two purity ratios. And the purity ratios allow us to get an idea of if there's any contamination, either through proteins or salts that may be co-extracted with our DNA extractions. So what I'll do is I'll just run another sample and I'll just show you how the auto run works. So we'll select the checkbox that gives us auto run, and I'll just load another sample on, and you'll see that will automatically measure. And with this sample, I've deliberately set one up so that it will show us contamination. So this is a sample that is contaminated by DNA extraction salts. So what you'll see is with this sample, it still looks pretty good according to the trace. But on the right-hand side, under our 260:230 ratio, you'll see a yellow triangle has appeared. And these are our contamination alerts. So the contamination alerts check our purity ratios and check to see if they fit within kind of accepted thresholds. And we can set those as custom values if we want to, but kind of the commonly accepted ones are hardwired in. And if we touch the yellow triangle, you'll see that we get a load of information here related to what might be the issue with the sample. Once we have a few samples in the system, and once we've run our samples, we can either swipe onto our report screen, or we have tabs along the top of the screen here. So we go to our report screen, and you can see the data that we've just captured is presented in a tabular format. And this includes our sample name, if we've chosen to put one in. If we want to put one in at this stage, we can edit the data from here. So in our table, we see the concentration, the units that we've measured in, and information on our purity ratios. And we can select the samples that we want to export and use our share button to bring up our export menu. And so this is one of the really nice features with the DS11. As I mentioned earlier, we can fully network this system. So we can set this up to have an email address of its own. We can save our email addresses into the system and just select where we want to send it to, click OK, and it will automatically generate a report, send out a CSV, a .csv file, that you can open in Excel or a similar sort of editor. It'll send that to our email address, and so when we get back to the office, it's there waiting for you. Alternatively, we also are able to send it to a shared folder on the network, so we can set up a network drive on the instrument. We can save it to USB, we can print to a label printer, or we also have the opportunity to send it to a network printer. A unique feature of the DS11 series is the option for an integrated 4-channel fluorometer. Now, it's important to consider absorbance and fluorescence as complementary methods for quantification in a lab. The advantage of fluorescence is that the fluorescence kits are very specific for a particular analyte. So a kit might be specific, for example, to double-stranded DNA. So when we use our double-stranded DNA kit, we're quantifying that to the exclusion of everything else. Now, in absorbance, all of our nucleic acids will absorb at 260 nanometers. So if we have contamination of RNA in a DNA sample, they'll all kind of contribute to that value at 260. A further advantage of fluorescence is that if you have low concentration samples, fluorescence has a higher sensitivity than absorbance. So we can take a look at the Donovix double-stranded DNA assays. You'll see that there are three assays: a broad range, a high sensitivity, and an ultra high sensitivity. And with these three assays combined, we can measure samples from 0.5 picograms per microliter all the way up to 4,000 nanograms per microliter. We also have an RNA assay, and you'll see from this graph that we have a single RNA assay that covers a much wider dynamic range than our main competitor in the market. So we can see that the Dynovix assays have the widest dynamic range on the market. However, for more concentrated samples, Dynovix's SmartPath technology using microvolume absorbents can go up to 37,500 nanograms per microliter. One of the key differences between absorbance and fluorescence, however, is, as we've already seen with absorbance, we can get an assessment of the contamination that might be in our sample. Whereas for fluorescence, what we get is just a quantification, so we get a concentration number, but no visibility on any potential contamination. So by combining absorbance and fluorescence, you get a highly specific, highly sensitive quantification with fluorescence, and you get contamination information from absorbance. Another feature of the DS11 series is that whenever data is captured in any of our measurement apps, it's automatically saved, and this data can be accessed from the data app on the home screen. We can see when we come into the data app that we have a number of ways of searching our data on the left-hand side by application. So we can select from a range of our applications here and just search within the data captured in those applications. We'll select double-stranded DNA. We could also search on sample name and on date range. And we'll just go ahead and we'll search on all of the data on this instrument. And you'll see it just takes a fraction of a second to search all of that and bring up all of the data that has been captured on this instrument. If we move to the top of the list, or we can order based on any of the headings, and we'll see that our data is presented here at the top. And we can select those and select some other samples that have been captured on previous days and simply add those to a report. And if we go to our report tab, we'll see that all of that data is now presented in tabular format in the same way as it is in our count apps. And we can go ahead and we can overlay data that's been captured on different measurement sessions in a graphical way. And we can export that in the same way as we can for any of our measurement apps. In addition to the apps that we've covered in this presentation, we also have apps for absorbance covering colorimetric assays such as BCA, Bradford or Lowry assays. We have applications for labeled DNA or labeled protein. We have OD600 for quantifying microbial cell cultures. And we have custom apps in both absorbance and fluorescence where you can define measurement parameters and calculations for assays where we don't have an application pre-programmed. We also have apps for kinetics and to measure peptides. In summary, the DS11 series has been installed in thousands of laboratories worldwide and is the only instrument to combine microvolume UV-Vis, cuvette absorbance and fluorescence in the same system. We encourage you to read our independent online reviews, where scientists currently using our platform highlight the ease of use of the software, the great results, the accurate, reproducible data, and the reliability and flexibility of the DS11 series. If you'd like to see more of the DS11 or any other instrument in the Dynovix range, visit dynovix.com to schedule an online demo with one of our applications team, or take advantage of our free trial program, where we'll ship an instrument to your lab for 1 week to test it on your samples with no obligation.